Thank you, brother.
It's just become the love of my life to play music. Touring doesn't come natural to me. And I think it doesn't come natural to a lot of people who started playing music in their bedroom, fantasizing about seeing the world, but staying still. And I'm from Fairfield, Connecticut. My parents didn't go places. You had to bring up a trip to go to another town weeks in advance before you could go to another town where I was from. So how do you get to be just one big sort of conceptual idea in your bedroom to play what I've just found out is 1,000 shows? You do it with your friends. It's the only way it works. I don't know that I would ever go on tour again if I had to do it with different people. I wouldn't do it. They're family. They really are family.
The best thing about touring is the familiarity that gets developed and bred through having the same crew day after day, year after year. The setting up shop and going from room to room and understanding how that works almost without any words at all, just tacitly understanding the flow of the day is one of my favorite things. You just wave hi to everybody as if it's an office building.
Artists are weird. It's a weird transition to grow up as both a person and an artist. And even when you're really successful, that adds to the weirdness of it, the growing pains. It's very strange. And if you're, number one, if you're lucky enough to figure out what you have, well, that's great, but sometimes you figure out what you had after you already lost it. And I am in this unbelievable position where I value it every single day of being in a place where I can appreciate what I have to a degree I can't really express to you. I'm just a collection of ideas. Just a guy in a room with a collection of ideas. Maybe I'll do this, maybe I'll be that. There's not as much person as I wish there was. I'm working on that part of it. But everything's sort of like an idea. And everyone who I work with, my entire team and family, take my ideas and form them into a really salient, understandable way to communicate what I write and how I play to the world. And I am nothing, literally nothing. I'm the guy at the back of the bar bragging about how good a guitar player he is in some small town without you guys. I love music more than anything. Touring is technology proof. They make a new cable for your phone every year and a half, but that fucking guitar cable is the same since like 1935.
that is they have given me the birthday present of my worst nightmare, which is beginning the wrong song. For a good 4 seconds, I was in complete abject misery because I went, what song? Run back, if you were filming that, get a look at me going back, going, oh my God, what is it supposed to be? And then, interestingly enough, what song is this? Oh, that was great.
Oh,
Just remember on the way home. You were never meant to feel alone. Back on the bus. See you next week if you need a mattress. You go back to love that's where you. I'll go back to your answer. How's that life? Sway your way. Grass is greener than these two. Just remember on the way home. Ooh. You were never meant to feel alone. Oh, just look me up, get back on the bus. I'll see you next week if you need a mattress. Who says I can't get started? Turn off the lights and the telephone. In my house alone. Who says I can't get started? Who says I can't be free from all of the things that I used to be? We're at nice to me. Who says I can't be free? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long night in Baton Rouge. Don't remember you looking any better. I don't remember you. Who says I can't get stoned? Call up a girl that I used to know. Fake love for an hour or so. Who says I can't get stoned? Oh, who says that I can't take time? Meet all the girls in the county line. We're all afraid to send a sign. Who says I can't take time? It's been a long night in New York City. It's bound to be a long night in Manchester too. Oh, I don't remember you looking at me. Thinking I don't remember you. Who says I can't get stoned? Plan a trip to Japan alone. There's a ladder if I even go. Who says I can't get stoned? It's been a long night in New York City. It's been a long time since traveling to. Thank you.
only weak, yeah. Love, I'm the weak, love, I'm the weak, yeah. I'm coming up and I'm loving every minute of it.
Thank you. to say so long. Maybe it's so wrong, but I'm moving on. Ooh, I wanna get a new girl, something I can do, girl, to try to get me through, girl, 'cause I'm moving.
side. Yeah, play some of that. This is really the greatest. Number one, it's my favorite city in the world, you might know that. But I just can't think of a better place to end a tour, and this has just been the greatest tour I've ever been on. Really, you know, gratitude is something that you find later on in your life. And everybody finds gratitude later on in their life, and they're happy and thankful for whatever they're left with as they come to and realize, oh, I should be happy with what I have. I should be grateful for what I have. I am so lucky that when I finally figured out how to be grateful for what I had, I realized I have you guys. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You didn't leave me. Thank you. Some of you I've met before, some of you I'm meeting for the first time tonight. This is a song maybe about that. This is a song about going my own way in my life and finally standing up for myself in that. It's called Changing. And if you know it, sing it along with me, because it probably feels good. One, two, three. I am not done changing. Out on the run, changing. I may be old, but I am not done changing. I met with someone changing. We had some fun changing. Sometimes I wonder if she'll be the one when I'm done changing. Some of us stopped running, some of us went home. Some of us don't got one, so we'll build one of our own. Friends behind the fences, looking at me strange, wondering when I'm gonna come to my senses. But I'm still changing, and I can't change. This is a song, number one. It's a song about when you're at your wit's end about being in a relationship where you tried everything and you're so desperate to try to make it work that you think to yourself, maybe we never need to talk. If we're always getting in fights because we talk, maybe we can have a completely non-verbal, are you hungry? You want apple? But then maybe it'll be okay. Maybe you can just never talk and stay together forever. It doesn't work. It's the thing after Let's Go to Therapy. Let's Go to Therapy buys you like one more week. You know what I mean? Like, all right, that's the, but then after that you're like, what if we never speak to each other, but we still are just like, mm-hmm. And the song was originally, I was like, maybe we'll call this Words, because it started out me saying, just don't say a word, just come home. Just come home. So, I think that's a beautiful thing, that love could make someone so desperate to make love work that they would subvert reality for a little while. I think that's one of the greatest things about it, is that it can subvert and distort reality. And anyway, that's what this song is. It's called Engine of Desire. Brown. I wrote this next song at a Borders Books in Marietta, Georgia. I had forgotten my guitar, if you can believe it or not. And I had left work, and I was headed down 85. And then I realized I had forgotten my guitar, but traffic going the other way was just absolutely bumper to bumper. That was a horrible feeling. I had no guitar, and I was going to my big gig at Borders Books. And they either gave you like $30 cash or like $50 store credit or something. So I took the $50 and I got a book on how to make more money, and here I am. That's how you do it, people. And this is no lie, I was so flustered. I borrowed a guitar from the great Sean Mullins, actually. I stopped by Sean Mullins' house because he was on the way. I need a guitar, I'm so sorry, you hardly know me. I know you think I'm a punk, can I please just borrow a guitar? And I borrowed his guitar, and there were the four people waiting for me, and God bless the four people waiting there. And it was me again, me versus the coffee machine. I didn't have that kind of firepower at the time. I only had a little PA, and they had a, I think it was a bun. I think it might have been a bun. I can't be sure. You know a bun, you ever see a bun? B-U-N-N. Anyway, I was just trying to think of a coffee book. And I was so frustrated that I just started making this song up. And the song was about how I had had this terrible afternoon. And that's where the song picks up. It goes like this.
I'm driving 85 in kind of morning. That's all afternoon. I'm just stuck inside the gloom. Four more exits to my apartment. I am tempted to keep the car in drive and leave this shit behind. Cause I want some time about the outcome of a stay.
Thank you so much.
As more loud words of encouragement from people who can really project, and they're men now, and I love this. It used to be women screaming when I was a younger guy, and now it's men, and you'd be surprised. They're more encouraging than you think. They're very Karate Kid sweep the leg. They're very like I'll turn around and get water, and I'll hear just one strong, clear voice throughout the girl going, "You got this, Johnny!" And I'm like, "Yeah, I do got this." It's very Cobra Kai. I enjoy it. Seems like it's like when I'm about to like take a foul shot or something. Yeah, no, it's nice. I like it. There's something about it. I mean, it's, you know, it's hyper familiar, and that's what, I think that's what I like about it. Yeah, I like it. Yeah.
I'm gonna die if I never see you.
last ring. I'm gonna stay and quit, cause I died my son, I died my dancing. Sunset says we say this all the time. Never mind. Never mind. I forgot how this part goes. And I always tell myself, sometime I'm gonna remember how it goes. And then I thought, maybe I'll just do it now or never, you know?
Watch your pretty life play out in pictures from afar. Wherever I go, wherever I go, I wonder where I am in my relationship to you. Wherever you go, wherever you are, watch your pretty life play out in pictures from afar.
This next song and I have a tumultuous relationship. We met when we were young. I was about 21 years old, and I wrote it in an apartment building in Atlanta, Georgia. And I went, "You seem nice." And then I went, "Oh, you're really nice." And then I put it on a record, and the world went, "This is really nice." And then we had a bit of a falling out, and I would say to it, "They think we're funny. They think we're a punchline. I worked my whole life to learn how to play the guitar and write songs, and all they do is talk about you." And the song said, "What's wrong with me?" "Well, nothing's wrong with you, but that's the only thing they know." So we didn't talk for a while. Went our separate ways. I wrote some other songs, met some other people, said some other things. And then not long ago, I would say about 2 years ago, I ran into this song out in the world, and it was looking pretty good. It had worked out. Turned out that over time, it maybe had morphed from being a silly college frat house kind of a song to representing some kind of innocence in my life that I'll never get back again. Because let me tell you something, you have to be very innocent to write a song called "Your Body is a Wonder." You gotta be greener than a mug, because if you knew any more about the world, you would know that that song might go down in history as being a little silly. But I'm gonna sing it to you tonight without any silliness at all. I'm gonna sing it with its intended sincerity. Yes, it has the phrase "bubblegum tongue" in it. And I'm even gonna sing that one from the heart. And I even know that you guys in some way are gonna dance and sing along to it ever so slightly ironically, and that's okay. Because that's what you're allowed to do with your past. You're allowed to ironically celebrate your past. So let's do it. Gentlemen who love the guitar, hang tight. Hang tight for 3.5 minutes.
We got the afternoon. You got this room for two. One thing I've left to do. Discover me, discovering you. Oh, one mile to every inch. Your skin like porcelain. One pair of candy lips and bubblegum tongue. 'Cause if you wonder what, swimming a deep sea, well, take on your big plans. Oh, this is bound to be wild. Your body's a wonderland. Your body's a wonder. I will use my hand.
Okay, that part's weird.
Your body's a wonderland. Something about the way the hair falls on your face. I love the shape you took when crawling towards the pillowcase. You tell me where to go, and though I might need to find it, I'll never let your head hit the bed without my hand behind it. Do you want my love or me? Swim in a deep sea, baby, up a leg. Take out your blinking plans and break them down. This is bound to be wild. Your body's a wonderland. Your body's a wonder. I use my hands. Your body's a wonderland. I know you're mine, oh mine, oh mine. But you look so good and hurt sometimes.
Oh, just like a maze. With all of the walls are continually changed. And I don't know I can to stand on the steps with my heart in my hands. Now I'm starting to see that it's got nothing to do with me. Fathers, be good to your daughters. Daughters will love like you do. Girls become lovers who turn into mothers. So mothers, be good to your daughters, to others. Since the day she saw him walking away, now I'm left cleaning up the mess he made. So fathers, be good to your daughters. Daughters will love like you do. Girls become lovers who turn into mothers. So mothers, be good to your daughters too. And boys, you can breathe. You find out how much they can take. 'Cause boys will be strong. Boys hold you on. The boys will be gone without one for a woman. Good. Oh, so look at that girl with the lights coming up in her eyes. You know she must be somebody's baby. You know she's got to be somebody's baby. You know she must be somebody's baby. Oh, 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 oh yeah. So fathers, be good to your daughters. Daughters will love like you do. Girls become lovers who turn into mothers. So mothers, be good to your daughters too. So mothers, be good to your daughters too. So mothers, be good to your daughters too.
She's a good girl, loves her mom, loves Jesus and America too. She's a good girl, crazy about Elvis, loves horses and a boyfriend too, and lets you know. It's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway running through the yard, and I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. Oh, I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart, and I'm free. Free falling, falling. Yeah, I'm free, yeah. Free falling, falling. Oh, and all the vampires, they're walking through the valley. They move west down Ventura Boulevard, and all the bad boys are standing in the shadows, all of the good girls. I'm with broken hearts, and I'm free. Free falling, falling. Yeah, I'm free, yeah. Free falling, falling.
Guess I just feel that. I guess I just feel that. Nobody's honest, nobody's true.
it on through. I guess I just feel like I'm the same way too. I feel
Thank you.
Change it if I want it. Can I?
remember, I don't know, being in my late 20s. And the trick about being in your late 20s is that it's the first time that you go to access some of your memories and they come up, error 404, file not found, broken JPEG icon. And that's a very scary thing because that was what you held on to. Well, every Christmas time, have yourself, oh, I remember. I can smell the carpet. I remember every hallway in the house. And then you get into your late 20s, and I just think it's based on how long the boat trip is. But you can't see the harbor behind you. You can't see where you left from. And that's a very frightening thing because you don't know what to hold on to, and your memories start fading. And that's a tricky thing. And then I remember at that age, right before I wrote this next song, hearing Christmas songs and crying because I couldn't find every last little imaginary friend and thing and shag carpet and first song and first movie and smell and touch. And it really knocked me for a loop because that's what I get by on. I spend more time in my memories holding on to these little things, and I think that's okay, you know? And when they first start to disappear, not disappear, but you just can't reach them whenever you want, that's just a scary, scary thing. And I wrote about that, and I was obsessed with it for a few years. Like, there are times, I don't drink anymore, but when I used to drink, I used to lay down on a bed and just obsess myself with time travel. Why can't I? Why can't I? They made clouds. They made oranges. They made all these other things. You tell me we can't go back in time, and I can't go back and sit on the shag carpet, and I can't listen to my first song wrapped around your finger off of MTV in 1983. I can't go back there. You tell me that's impossible? And then I discovered a new kind of here. And that's when everything gets okay, when you realize it's a very fair trade. It's a very fair trade. The world liked you as a child, but needs you as an adult. The world needs you. And it's all fair, it's all okay. But I still wanna go back in time. And I still wanna stop this train. I'll never, ever stop wanting to stop this train.
I'm only good at being young. So I play the numbers game and find a way to say life has just begun. Hands out with my old man, said help me understand. He said 1068, you renegotiate. Don't stop this train. Don't go with any judgment, please. Love me. Don't think I could it ever understand. I tried my best, John.
Still feel like you're mad. stone before the calm. This is the deep and dying river. This love that we've been working on. Can't seem to hold you like I want to. So I can feel you in my arms. Nobody's gonna come and save you. We put so many false alarms. We're going down. And you can see it too. We're going thank you.
Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. This many years in, this many records in, this many new artists younger than me in. Thank you guys for carving out time in your life to come sing all of these songs. I only hope we played most of the songs that all of you wanted to hear. And something occurred to me in the middle of the show tonight that you can't play for 2.5 hours unless you... Yes, you can. But watch me. You can't play for 2.5 hours. Cliffhanger, there's more. Without having an incredible band on stage to be playing all of this music on the floor that you're shocking the power. David is saying, we're here the moment we go on as we say our fake goodnight. Because I'll tell you, when we say goodnight, that's not the answer. That's how it is, I don't know. It's like Groundhog Day. Groundhog always needs a shout. I learned very few years ago that that's what the case was. And there's always an encore. But unless you all walk out. But I would still plan to play it for NPCs, just because I'm a fighter and I don't give up. Please make as much noise as you can for this incredible band on stage. Tiffany Palmer, ladies and gentlemen. Carlos Ricketts. David Ryan Harris. Aaron Draper. Pino Palladino. Aaron Sterling.
Don't worry, it's a visual gag, Aaron. It's not working anymore.
Isaiah Sharkey. Jamie the Hover at the Keys. Thank you for letting us open up for ourselves tonight. I appreciate it. Thank you all for coming out. It is the joy of my life to play music for you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. And everyone right now.
Oh,
heart can stand. Dream of ways to throw it all away. Will you sing it with me?
Baby, I'm always, baby, I'm always.
I wrote this song because I wanted to dance. And the whole time I worked on this song, I danced. Every time, I liked it. Sometimes I write songs I like a lot. Most songs I write because I need to and come from a certain place. But some songs I write and I like it the whole time. I think I'll like this song the rest of my life. It's one for me every once in a while. And the whole time I was making the song, playback, it would just make me do this. You can't fake happy feet. If someone says they're fine and they're not, and you think they're not fine, ask them to do this. If they're not fine, they can't do this. This is proof that you're all right. So I would do this in the studio and it made me so happy. And then I did a video for $6,000. It was the biggest video I ever did in my life. Go figure. It was just me doing what I did in the studio. And so we're gonna do it tonight live. I'm gonna dance for you live. I went to Tokyo to do a live dance. This is what we do. We dance sometimes. The only bad dancing is dancing you don't commit to. I just commit to this dancing and it's great. Because I commit to it. You ready? Yeah. Hey, even if you can't dance, you know, your shoulders, dance with your shoulders. Send the right one in, and maybe send the left one in. And just dance and dance and dance. All right, let's do it.
All alone, pushing forward in the friend zone. running through my veins for you.
Thank you.